It was human spirit that was reborn after the long slumber of Middle Ages, and this birth is known as Renaissance. Hello friends, welcome to my channel ELS, English Literature Studies with Core Harpreet. Today I'm going to discuss what is the influence of Renaissance on English literature. So let us start with the video. The word Renaissance is derived from two words, that is re and sense. It was human spirit that was reborn after the long slumber of Middle Ages. This reawakening or rebirth was brought about by a revival in the culture and civilization of ancient Greece and Rome. The study of classical Greek and Roman art and literature came to be called as humanism and its devotees as humanists. Humanism simply means the religion of humanity or devotion to human or secular interests as opposed to divinity. This learning of humanism brought about a revolutionary change in the life and outlook of the people. It was a change of emphasis from the religion to the secular. People began to value life for its own sake and not merely as a preparation ground for that in the next world. This secular spirit marked the end of Middle Ages and the beginning of new era, the age of Renaissance. We use the term Renaissance to cover the whole movement whose essence was that man so long blinded had suddenly opened his eyes. Renaissance had its birth in Italy and slowly it spread in Germany, France and England. In England, Elizabethan period from 1579 to 1602 was manhood from Renaissance. It introduced genius like Shakespeare, Marlowe, Spencer and Sidney. These names are very important to learn. Most of the Elizabethans came under the influence of Renaissance. Milton's work reflect both Renaissance and Reformation. It was left for him to harmonize these two opposing forces into a perfect whole. The Renaissance element shows themselves in Milton in two ways. It means we can see Renaissance element in Milton's work in two ways. First one is they provide the classical framework for most of his major poetical works. And number two, they humanize and somewhat secularizes Puritanism. Almost all the works of Milton are embodiment of Renaissance and Reformation, and his Paradise Lost is a product of the spirit of Reformation. Its purpose, in Milton's own words, is to justify the ways of God to men. So this is mingling of Renaissance and Reformation in Paradise Lost. Justify the ways of God to man, which is totally a biblical theme. In Italy, Dante is the last representative of the Middle Ages. Petrarch, a poet who came after him, wrote about love of nature and glories of ancient Rome. People were delighted by his work and he was crowned poet laureate by them. He was joined by Boccaccio, who delighted his countrymen with stories of love, laughter and poems of love and passion. Petrarch and Boccaccio were interested in past achievements of ancient buildings, beautiful statues, old forgotten manuscripts. They were earliest humanists. Their work marks the dawn of Renaissance. Renaissance was an event in the midst of intellectual revolution that gave rise to new scholarship. Now, one thing I would like to clear here. What is the intellectual revolution? Let me tell you. In 1453, Constantinople was taken by the Turks. This city has long been the capital of Greek Empire. When Turks became masters of Constantinople and later of Greece, many of Greek left their country and passed over into Italy, taking with them the treasures of ancient literature and art. Here they taught their language to the Italians. The opening of treasures of Greek literature to the people of 15th century was like the discovery of a new world. So this is the intellectual revolution. Let me continue. Renaissance was an event in the midst of intellectual revolution that gave rise to new scholarship. Greeks, due to Turkish pressure, fled to West along with their precious library, as I've already told you. They were welcomed in Italy and Florence under the patronage of great family of Medici. With the fall of Constantinople, the Greek scholars flew to Italy and the Italians learnt more about Homer, Plato and Aristotle. A new treasure of ancient Greece added more to the treasure of ancient Rome. So friends, this was all about what is the influence of Renaissance on English literature. My upcoming videos will be regarding features of Renaissance and what is the impact of Renaissance, what is its impact on prose and what is its impact on poetry. So I hope you will like my video, and if you like it, please don't forget to share and subscribe, and don't forget to hit the bell button so that you can get notifications for my upcoming videos. And stay tuned to continue this lecture with me, what impact of Renaissance on prose and poetry. So this is all about today's video. Let us discuss in another parts. So thanks for watching.